Yeah, it's really the struggle between Amadeo and and Flash, which is the best player in the world, who comes back to his hometown to own it and destroy everything that reminds him of the only failure he had in life, which was a foosball game in his childhood. So it's up to Amadeo and his foosball players to fight for his town again, in the way to find the love of his life and the friendship and the great man that he is within himself. I always found humor to be an integral part of all the movies that I've done, even in The Secret in Their Eyes, which is so dark and so perverted in a way. It has a lot of humor in it. I wanted to talk about the passion, basically, in a way that children could understand and could comprehend and could be involved into it. I saw my experience of animated movies, which I love, was that they moved me, but they didn't move the kids. The kids only got involved in the adventure aspect of it. So I wanted to provide that, but I also wanted the kids to feel that, to be moved. And it's really what happens, it makes me very happy to see kids yelling and cheering and hating, insulting at the characters. It's really becomes the last half hour of the game, of the movie. It's like if you were in a football stadium. I'm a big fan of English television, English movies. I think that the English TV with American TV are the best. It's the best in the world. I love the comedy. They're trendsetters in terms of comedy. So I knew many of these actors. I was a big fan. When their names were presented to me, I couldn't believe it. I knew that the UK version was going to be better even than the original version. If there is such a thing as an original version in an animated movie, I mean, they're all dubbed anyway. So I'm very happy with this version. I'm very happy that UK kids will be able to see it in their own language, not in a foreign English, with their own accent, with their own references. And there are parts that I think that surpass previous translations of the movie. The commentators in the game, they really make it come alive. It's really hilarious. I think they're great. From a technical point of view, this was by far the most complex project I've been involved in, because everything is created in a computer. The Secret in Their Eyes was difficult because reproducing the 70s, it doesn't look like a fantasy film, it doesn't look like a science fiction film, but it has a lot of visual effects. But this one, everything is a visual effect. The texture of the clothes, the texture of the skin, the extras, everything is created in the computer. So the technical challenges are amazing, are incredible. They're usually not, you need the computing power of five banks to make a movie like this one. So we were always scrambling for more computers, more computers, more computers. And the cast, the crew was from all over the world. It was really the best. We got the best from every country. But the technical challenges were just, we were always finding, bumping against our limits and then getting more stuff. And then again, the limits and more stuff. And the more we got, the more we wanted to make. The better we got at it, the better we wanted to make. So we were always pushing our limits. And it was tough, technologically speaking. It's hard for me to talk about about the film, but in a good way, just because of education prevents me from it. I can see my father saying, "Never speak about yourself." But the final game, I think that it hits all the notes that we try to hit. The main thing of it is that the result of a game, the numbers of goals, the score of a game is not the most important thing. That you have to play for other things. That there are things that are more important than the final score. That to me is the most important part of the movie.